Clarksville police arrest a man they say was selling fake tickets to an Indiana Pacers-Miami Heat game online. He was making multiple copies of the same printed ticket, and police believe there may be more victims. WLKY's Erica Coghill has the story.
It used to be if you wanted tickets somewhere, you'd wait in long lines at different ticket booths like this one here at the KFC Yum Center. But with technology advancing, you're now able to buy those online. Makes it easier for you, but it also makes it much easier for thieves to defraud you. Police say this man, 22-year-old Justin O'Neill, sold fake Indiana Pacers Miami Heat tickets to people at $40 a pop. Most tickets for the big upcoming game are going for a couple hundred dollars.
Two tickets at face value for this game is definitely too good to be true.
Police say O'Neill was selling them on Facebook.
This guy was friends with people on Facebook, but they didn't really know him.
Police got in contact and set up a meeting.
He sold the same two tickets that he had previously sold to other people to an undercover officer, and we made an arrest at that time.
Police say the scam started when O'Neill somehow got a hold of two purchased tickets through a legitimate site. The problem is, though, once you print your tickets, you can make as many copies as you'd like. At this point, police say he sold the tickets to an undercover officer and two other people.
So we want to find out how many victims there are, if there's anybody else who's came forward. We believe that he's probably sold to several people, the exact two same tickets, exact same section.
They have a warrant to search O'Neill's phone, hoping his records may reveal the victims.
We're afraid there's going to be a lot of people show up to that ball game and have the same tickets. So try to save people a trip to Indianapolis. And
if you think you may be a victim, you're asked to contact Clarksville police. As far as avoiding ever becoming a victim in a situation like this, police say just stick to buying tickets the old-fashioned way or go online and make sure you're purchasing them through a legitimate ticket supplier like Ticketmaster. Erica Coghill, WLKY News.
O'Neill is facing three felonies: fraud, counterfeiting, and theft. He remains in the Clark County Jail on a $7,500 bond.